on Dishes. It's Deluxe Dave Dishin coming out with you with the fourth day of Deluxe's Daily December Dish. I'm just really happy to be here. We're very, 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 very close to Christmas Day. It's only very, very close. You see, I got my tree and everything. You guys just try to get over there. It's already set up. Everything is under there. The tree is all nice and decorated and lovely and everything like that. So I'm really happy and excited. I hope everybody's going to have a really great Christmas. I will be coming at you with a special Christmas message. I'm not probably going to talk about a lot on Christmas Day. I don't have a lot to talk about today, but I am going to do my top five. But make sure you keep it locked right here for that. But first, I do want to talk to you really quickly about an article that I was reading about The Dream. I've read a couple of articles about him within the past like weeks or so, and the first one was about him not getting a Grammy Award, and he was going off about that and talking about how the Grammys wasn't treating him right, and he wasn't getting such and such, and then he catches himself going off on Mariah Carey so-called fans on his Twitter page, saying that, you know, you're not a true Mariah Carey fan if you don't like any of the songs that he came up with on Mariah Carey's album. Let's put it this way, you guys. This is how I look at it. I say, if you are Mariah Carey, I like Mariah Carey's album. I listened to Memoirs. I listened to it on my way back from work today. I listened to it. I love this. The album is great. You're either going to like it or you're not going to like it. There are songs on there that he did, you know, and, you know, some people don't like his songs. You can't force anybody to sit up there and just like their song if they're on the album. So, I mean, this is what gets me, you guys. This is what I really want to get to the nitty-gritty about. Anyway, I want to get to the point, in fact, of everything. These egos are out of control, y'all. Male artists have these egos out of this world. It seems like from everybody, from Trey Songz to... I mean, you have the right to be cocky about what you do. You start busting on veterans like Trey Songz trying to come up against R. Kelly. You know, R. Kelly is a veteran. He's been in the game for a very long time, so I don't necessarily agree with these younger artists that are trying to claim that they are this and that this early in the game. Y'all have just come out with a couple albums. Keep the egos down. You got a big ego. Such a huge ego. You know, you got a big ego, but you got to keep your ego down. You know what I'm saying? I don't believe in having that huge ego when you're just new in the game. So that's really what I wanted to get at. Dream, you know, we love your stuff. I love listening to the Dream stuff. You can't force anybody to like what you come out with. The Grammys have their own choice of who they choose for their thing. So keep your head on. Keep coming out with stuff. And then I heard this news that the Dream said he's done. He's just done with everything. He's done with writing, and, you know, he's done everything that he has to do. Yo, Dream, I understand you said you've done everything you got to do, but just keep popping out your stuff. People's albums are not selling as well as they used to. All the new computer stuff is out now. Keep your head straight. Keep your eyes focused. That's all I got to say. That's all I really want to talk about today is the egos of the male artists. That it just seems like they're all out here doing a thing. We have so many female artists out here doing their thing, and they're all able to be good in the game. People compare them to each other, but they all have a special unique talent that each one of them has, and I appreciate them. Keep plugging your stuff out. Keep doing what you do, y'all. Anyways, keep it locked right here for my top five coming up right here on Deluxe Day. Today I'm bringing you my top five male actors. Today I put it together, and this is who I think were the top five actors of this year. My number five actor was brought to me by somebody that helps me out with the show, Heather. She loves this actor, and I have to give him his props because he's really been grinding out this year. He's been doing some great things this year. Columbus Short is my fifth, number five top actor. He's really been doing a great job. He's coming out with some things next year, which you should be looking out for, Santiago 2. This year he came out with his movie Armored. He's really, really been doing a great job, and he was in another movie, Whiteout, which I did not get a chance to see, but he's really been grinding it out this year. Columbus Short gets my top five male actor part. Number four was Brad Pitt. Brad Pitt came out with Inglourious Basterds. He did a great job, knockout job in there. Brad Pitt gets my number four top male actor spot. Number three, Obsessed. Idris Elba. I'm telling you, this dude, be looking for him. Be looking for him. He was in Obsessed. He was also in Daddy's Little Girl, if you saw that, with Tyler Perry. Idris Elba is really, really good. You know, the thing I like about him is every time he gets up and acts, you would never know that he was from the UK or anything like that. He talks with a perfect English accent. You would never even know that he was from another country or whatever, because he does a really, really good job at what he does. Number two, Denzel Washington gets my number two top actor spot. Denzel Washington came out with his Taking a Pelham 1-2-3 or 3-2-1 or whatever it's called. I didn't get a chance to see it. But Denzel Washington, he hasn't been doing a lot this year, but he's doing just enough to get my top two male actor spot. Number one, we're giving it to Morgan Freeman. Morgan Freeman, hands down. If y'all see anything that Morgan Freeman puts his hands on, he does a good job. I give him my number one male actor spot. Tomorrow, we're taking a little break because we're going to have our special Christmas episode of the Deluxe Day Edition. So make sure y'all watching that tomorrow. I will catch y'all tomorrow.